Hey, it's May, the temperature is rising, and so is the housing market here in Austin, Texas. If you want to know how the local market is doing, stay tuned for my next episode. Hi, I'm Sharmila Mehta with Keller Williams Realty here in Austin, Texas. Welcome to Champagne with Sharmila, a video series where we discuss everything related to homes. Well, it's May, and May is end of many things. It's the end of the school year, it's the end of college for a lot of people. My daughter is graduating, so it's end of her undergraduate studies. It feels like it's end of spring, even though official end of spring is in June, the temperature is rising. So we have all these celebrations going around us, and in the midst of all of that, the temperature of the Austin housing market is also rising. So it's that time of the month when we do market update. Let's look at four different things that kind of tell you the health of the housing market. First thing, we're going to talk about interest rate. Second thing, we're going to talk about inventory. Third, days on market. And lastly, we're going to talk about the average and median sales price. So as most of you know, we've had some trade tension with China, and as a result, we had, you know, the stock market falling last couple of weeks. And when the stock market falls, bonds do really well. And when bonds do well, the mortgage rates go down. So for people in the housing market, it's good news if you're a buyer or an investor. And it's also good news for sellers, because when buyers are ready to buy, sellers are happy because, you know, they have clients who are going to look at their homes. So interest rates right now are at about 4.125% for a 30-year fixed. But remember, interest rates depend on many different factors. What is your income to debt ratio? What is your credit score? So this is just to give you a general idea, but please consult your mortgage broker before you make a decision in terms of what is, you know, your affordability ratio. Let's look at inventory. Well, last month we had talked about the inventory being at about 3 months. Now it's at 2.7 months. So it is still a very strong seller's market, because the average, if you're at about 6 months inventory, then you call it a balanced market. But we're definitely way below that, and it is a seller's market. In fact, to give you a perspective, in 2010, there were about 12,600 homes available around this time of the year in the Austin metropolitan area. Last month in Austin, there were 8,600 homes, so exactly 4,000 homes fewer than what we had about 9 years ago. Now, the interesting thing is we have about 150 people moving to Austin every day, which translates to about 450,000 people who have moved to Austin between 2010 and 2019. So we have almost 500,000 people who have moved here, but we don't have homes for them, because we have had 32% fewer homes available to buy. So that kind of gives you a perspective of, you know, the housing market here in Austin. There are areas where homes are selling very quickly because there's just, you know, nothing available. And of course, you know, if you're a luxury, if you're in the luxury market, things are different. So that kind of gives you a perspective of the inventory. The days on market, which also kind of tells you the health of the market, we are at about 59 days on market. And what that means is that if you were to put your house on the market today, it will take you about 2 months to sell. Again, it all depends on where you are. If you're in the luxury market, it may take longer at a higher price point. If you are in certain pockets where there's a lot of demand because the schools are great and, you know, location is fabulous, you may sell in just a matter of few days with multiple offers. But in general, average 60 days on the market. And finally, I'm going to tell you what the average sales price is and what the median sales price is. Well, the median sales price is at $302,000, which is slightly above what it was same time last year. And the median, I'm sorry, the average sales price is at $410,000, which is also slightly, you know, about 1% over what it was last year. So yes, there has been an increase in median and sales price. However, that increase is not what it was, you know, a few years ago. Between 2012 and 2015, that increase was like 7 to 9% every year. We are out of that craziness. So it is a stabilizing market, which is, you know, a good sign for a lot of buyers and investors. And if you're a seller, this is a time for you to definitely get off the fence and put your house on the market before the market starts, you know, correcting. That's all, folks. If you have any questions and you need me to guide you in terms of your buying and selling needs, please feel free to get in touch with me. We can do a one-on-one consultation. If you find this information helpful, please like, share, and give me your comments. I hope this was helpful, and until next time, I'm Sharmila.